Hello everyone, in this video we'll talk about the specific gravity of solids and unit weight of soil determination. For more such videos and solved examples, you can sign up on our website abscd.in, the link for which is given in the description. So if we talk about the specific gravity of solids, so we had understood it earlier that it is the weight of solids to the weight of an equivalent volume of water. That is, here in the numerator we have the weight of solids and in the denominator we have the weight of an equivalent volume of water. That is, if Vs is the volume which is occupied by these solids of weight Ws, then what will be the weight of water in this given volume? So we are taking the volume Vs and multiplying it with the unit weight of water. So that way we find out the weight of an equivalent volume of water. So with the help of experiment also, we just need to figure out these two terms, that is weight of solids and weight of an equivalent volume of water. For this experiment or for the determination of specific gravity, here also we use picnometer, similar to water content determination, but instead of a wet soil, here we take the sample of a dry soil. The soil has to be dried up first. So we take a dry soil sample, and initially, I mean, we have these four readings. First reading is empty picnometer bottle. Second reading is the bottle filled with some dry soil. Third reading is in the remaining volume, whatever is the remaining volume, we fill the water and then take out the air also, whatever entrapped air may be present, and close the cap. That's the third reading. And in the fourth reading, we have filled this picnometer bottle completely with water. So first of all, we need to find out the weight of solids or weight of dry soil, we can say. So that is very easy. We can use these first two readings. So we can say the weight of dry soil will be equal to W2 minus W1. We just have to remove the weight of the container. Now we have to find out the weight of water having same volume as that of soil solids. That is, what will be the weight of water in this volume Vs. So here this volume is Vs. So we need to find out, if we fill water in this volume, then what will be its weight. So we can use these two readings for that, W3 and W4. So W4 gives us the weight of water if the whole container is filled with water. I mean, we have to deduct for the container volume. So we can write W4 minus W1 is the weight of water if the whole container is filled with water. Now we have to deduct this part of water. In this part, we have some more water. So we have to deduct for that. So we can say W4 minus W1 minus W3 minus W2. So in W3, we have the weight of solids plus water, and in W2, we have the weight of just solids. So if we deduct the weight of solids from this W3, so here we'll have the weight of water which is filled in this upper part. In this part, whatever water is present, we are getting the weight of that. And in this fourth reading, we have the weight of the water filled in the whole container. So deducting these two, we'll find out the weight of water in this bottom part. That's what we are looking for here, weight of water which is occupied by the same volume as that of solids. So that can be obtained using this equation. If we rearrange the terms here, so we can write it as W2 minus W1 minus W3 minus W4. So then we can write the specific gravity of solids as W2 minus W1, which is nothing but the weight of solids, we can say. So weight of solids divided by, again, W2 minus W1. So weight of solids minus W3 minus W4. So using this equation, we can find out the specific gravity of soil solids with the help of a picnometer. So here also, it is easier to just remember the method, how we are doing it, instead of just remembering this final equation. Because once you have understood what we have done in this experiment with the help of picnometer, then it is very easy to find out the specific gravity. Then let's talk about the unit weight of soil, or how do we determine the unit weight of soil. So there are a few methods which are used for it. First one is the core cutter method. Then there is sand replacement method. Third one is water displacement method. And fourth one is water balloon method. So let's see one by one how do we obtain the unit weight of soil, or we can obtain the density also with the help of these methods. So first we have the core cutter method. So in this method, there is a metal core, that is we have this cylindrical core which is completely open, and so we place it on the soil surface where we for the soil where we want to find out the unit weight, and with the help of a hammer this core is inserted into the soil. So it is inserted, and when it is taken out, it will be completely filled with soil. Then we can find out the weight of this soil. The volume of container is already known. Generally it is 1000 cc. So we know the weight of the soil, we know the volume of the container. Weight by volume will give us the unit weight. So here we'll obtain the bulk unit weight of the soil. And if we find out the water content, if we determine the water content, then with the help of that, we can find out the dry unit weight also. So we know gamma D is equal to gamma T upon 1 plus W. So using this equation, we can find out the dry unit weight if we know the water content. So here, if we talk about the readings, so initially we'll have the reading of, the weight of the core cutter itself, empty core cutter, Then we'll have weight of core cutter plus weight of soil. And the third reading we'll have the, this will be known, that is the volume of the cutter. So we can just find out the unit weight as W2 minus W1 divided by V. So this method is suitable for cohesive soil, because if you imagine this method to be applied for a cohesionless soil, then even if we insert this cutter, this soil will not hold inside the cutter, it will just come out. So it is not suitable for cohesionless soil. So we can use other methods for that. The next method what we have is sand replacement method. So in this method, how we determine the volume of the hole, that will be different. Basically unit weight, as I said, it is given as weight by volume. So here we take out some soil from the place where we want to find out the unit weight. So weight of the soil will be known very easily. We'll just dig a hole and take out that whole soil and measure its weight. So weight of the soil is easy, but we have to find out the volume of this hole. So for that, we have this hole method. So we have a container here of cylindrical shape, and there is a conical bottom here. Now we fill this container completely with sand and then do our experiment. So first of all, we also find out what is the weight of the sand that will be filling this conical part. So there is a tap given here, and before starting this experiment, we can turn this knob so that the sand comes out. We'll keep it on a flat surface, so this sand will fill in this conical part, and for that we can measure the weight. So we know what is the weight of the sand that will fill in this conical part. Now once we have done that, again we can fill this container, and then we place it on this hole where we have taken out the soil. So here we place it on this hole, and again we open the knob. So again this time the sand will fill this hole of the soil as well as this conical part, but we are interested only in the weight of the soil or weight of the sand that is filling in this hole, not in the conical part. So we can deduct the weight. Let's say here we obtain the total weight as WS1, that is S for sand I'm denoting. So WS1 we took as the weight, and here the sand which was filling this conical part, its weight is WS2. So if we take the difference WS1 minus WS2, so that will give us the weight of sand in the hole. That's what we are interested in. And if we know the unit weight of sand, once we know the unit weight of sand, then we can find out the volume. Volume will be simply this WS1 minus WS2 divided by unit weight of sand. That will give us the volume of this hole. And if we know the volume, then we can use this equation to find the unit weight. Now, unit weight of sand is very easy. Again, we can use the same container. For this part, we know the volume. If we fill it with sand, so we can measure its weight, and weight by volume will give the unit weight of this sand. That's what we are interested in. So using this method, we can find out the unit weight of the soil. Then we have the next method, that is water displacement method. So this method uses the Archimedes principle for measuring the unit weight of a soil. So here we take a container and completely fill it with water. This will be filled up to top, and then we put another container below this container. Now if we take a soil mass and drop it into the container, so what will happen? Some water will be displaced from the sides. Now the volume of water that will be displaced here, that will fill in the bottom container, this volume of water will be same as the volume of soil. So if we know the volume of soil, then it is very easy. It is simply weight by volume for obtaining the unit weight. Now the difficulty here is that if we drop this soil in water, then it is just probably going to disintegrate. That this soil mass, it will not hold as a lump, it will just disintegrate. So we don't want that to happen. Now to avoid that, what we do, we put a coating of paraffin wax around the soil mass, and then we can dip it in water. Now the problem that will come is that the volume of water, what we'll obtain here, it will be volume of soil plus volume of wax, but we only want the volume of soil. Now for that we need to find out the volume of wax and deduct it from this reading. So for that we use the unit weight of wax. Unit weight of wax is known to us. Now with the help of that we can find out the volume of wax. That is, here we take the first reading as the weight of soil, I mean whatever weight of soil we are taking, this inner part, this is our first reading. Then the second reading we take as the weight of soil plus, I mean once we put the paraffin wax, again we weight it. So weight of soil plus weight of wax, that will be the second reading. Then taking these two readings, we can find out the weight of wax, that will be W2 minus W1. Once we know the weight of wax and unit weight of wax, we can find out the volume of wax, that is weight of wax divided by its unit weight. And if we know the volume of wax, we can put it in this equation to find out the volume of soil. And once we know the volume of soil, we can use that to find out the unit weight of soil. So that's how we use the water displacement method. Then there is one more method that is known as the water balloon method. So in some cases where the cohesionless soil is present and these particles are also a very large size, it is difficult to measure the volume. So once we take out these some weight from this hole, I mean wherever we want to measure the unit weight, we'll take out the soil which is made of relatively larger particles. Once we do that, then we put a polythene in this hole. I mean we use a thin polythene which will settle with the boundary of this hole itself, and then we fill the water. Now we know the weight of these of the soil that we have taken out, and whatever is the volume of water which is filling this hole, we can figure that out also. So that will give us the volume of the hole, and weight by volume we can find out the unit weight of water. So that is the water balloon method. I hope you found this video useful. Please like, subscribe and share this video with your friends.